What's up, everybody? Derek Lambert here, and hit that subscribe button, like, share. Someone might need to hear this message. I'm chilling out on the front porch. It's about 12 p.m., maybe 1 a.m. approximately, Saturday night, and having a good Happy New Year's here in 2019. I wanted to share with you guys a little bit of my story with Subutex and Suboxone. I don't recall going into much detail and sharing kind of what led up to me going that route, and I'm going to touch on methadone. So probably going to title this something to do with methadone, Suboxone, and Subutex, my experience. Just to give you guys flat out, I'm not pushing it or not pushing it against you, or I'm not for or against at this point. I'm just going to give you my experience because it can be done, okay? It can be done, and it can keep you from having to use the stuff on the streets, okay? And that's the last thing we want you to do is stay on the streets, okay? That is the last thing we want. But I go to say that to say, I was trying to get off Opanas years and years ago, and I had tried multiple times. I'd relapse, went back, came back and forth, and would struggle and get clean and then get back on, and you know, the battle of addiction that just kept going for me. And what happened was I went to the methadone clinic because I thought, well, I need something strong enough. These Opanas are no joke. I went and talked to the doctor. I wasn't sleeping good. And I ended up going and seeing the doctor up there. They told me, hey, take the piss in the test, take this piss test, piss in this cup, and, you know, make sure we test you and see what you're all on before we give you any medication. They started me out at like 20 milligrams and worked me up 5 milligrams from there each day. And I was upset. I was so self-centered at that time. I was like, why didn't I get 25 milligrams the first day? You know, I had found out other people got 25 their first day or whatever. Either way, I started building up, and I think I got to like 40, 45 or something like that. And, you know, they wanted me to take a couple days before I climbed to the next level. My goal was to go up there in order to feel a high, to feel a buzz, so that I didn't want to keep using the drugs on the streets, which is much better than damn doing whatever's on the streets, shooting up this bag that you don't know what's in it. But in my case, I was just snorting Opanas, which is, I'm not saying that's better. None of this shit's better, but I was in there trying to get help. And I remember on the methadone, I came home to take a nap after I went there at 5 in the morning, waiting in line around plenty of people that I'm looking, and I'm thinking to myself, holy shit, am I gonna be doing this? Like, these guys are telling me war stories in line to get the methadone, and I felt like, holy crap, man, these stories are no joke. This is some serious shit. I don't want to end up staying, you know, doing this shit for my life. And these guys are like, yeah, I've been doing methadone for 10 years up in New York, and I came down here, and I'm like, 10 years? Bro, what the hell kind of, you know, to me, like, what the hell is this? That's what's going on in my head. I'm thinking, that's ridiculous, 10 years. So, anyway, I digress on that. I ended up going home after taking my 45 milligram dose to take a nap. I felt tired, and I took this nap while laying on my back. And I remember waking up, and I could not feel anything from my neck down to my feet. I had no feet, I had no legs, I had no torso, I had no arms. All I felt was like numb. Everything was completely numb. I had never experienced that. And I started to panic because I couldn't move for a second. Then all of a sudden I turned and rolled over. Poof, I could feel my body again. Now, I've not heard another methadone person who's ever said that they've experienced that kind of experience. So it's extremely rare that something like that probably happens, that you would experience that. But that was my experience, and it freaked me out so bad. I was like, I don't want to do this. But I was trying to find also an excuse to feel high again, I suspect. I can't even remember as many times as I've attempted to get clean and failed and attempted and was successful for a while. I can't remember if I got clean for a time then or not. That's how confused the timing and the life I had was on getting clean and not being clean. Anyways, I ended up, I guess somehow years later, I was going to this church I got excommunicated from. That's a whole nother story. But I was going to this church, and there were some people in the church who cared about me, and they wanted to help me out. So they said, listen, and the guy's wife was also dealing with addiction. She was going to the clinic, and she said, look, you can get on Suboxone or Subutex. I had no clue what this was. I didn't have money to get any of this. And in North Carolina, you have to pay to get Suboxone, Subutex, or Methadone. None of it's free. I heard Methadone's free in New York and areas like that. So I end up going to this clinic, and I don't really want to go, but I'm like, these people were enticing me in a way, persuading me in a way, that I decided, all right, I'll get them off my back, I'll try. And I care about them, so I get the persistence of a non-addict wanting to help an addict, and I can appreciate that, because sometimes it does break through. I end up going to this damn clinic and talking to the doctor, and he's talking about, you need to take you need to wait a certain amount of time because of the naloxone that's inside of the Suboxone. It'll kick you into withdrawal. But if you really want to start right now without the withdrawal, you need to get on Subutex. It's cheaper too. And I'm like, duh, let's do Subutex. They gave me a dose that day. I can't remember what it was, 2 milligrams, 1 milligram. I can't remember because it's a different type of milligram than what you would compare to methadone or even Suboxone. And it's a little different than the Suboxone. So I take this 1 milligram, 2 milligrams. I start going a couple days, and I started cheating because I wanted to get high. See, your head has to be in the game if you're really going to do this thing right. So I end up taking like a milligram at a time, and Kurt starts going to the clinic. I think Kurt was going to the clinic at this time. I think he was, or no, he wasn't. Maybe he could afford it. We're battling this thing. But I had jackets on because it was winter time at the time. So I would go in, and they'd have the little cup. They'd crush it in front of you, the Subutex. They had the little white cup. They pour it in the cup. And here you are. Here's your cup. Take it in front of me. Drink your water. Bye. Right? Some people will leave it in their mouth to let it dissolve and kick in better, all that stuff. Well, I would play this trick where I would act like I grabbed it with both hands and I'd pour it down my sleeve, and the crumbs would rest right here at the bottom of my jacket. And I would, thank you, have a good day. And I'd walk out. And while walking out, I'm passing all these people. I'd go out and there'd be a plate in my car, and I'd get the sprinkles of all the Subutex out onto the plate and give it to Kurt. Because Kurt was sick and didn't have anything, and I would use that day. Or if I wasn't using and I was using Subutex and Kurt was using, it was just, I was using it so I didn't hurt. At some point during this time, something clicked for me and I started taking it a little serious. I said, all right, I'm just going to really take the Subutex as needed. I think I might have got caught or something happened. So I ended up taking the Subutex as required, and I was on it for months. I can't remember. I was on it for months, and I was successful. I weaned off of it, and I didn't have to have anything. And I think that was when I had my 2 years clean. I can't remember. It blurs. But I successfully got off Subutex through the doctors weaning me down at the clinic. It can be done. I just know that if your head isn't in the game and you're replacing a chemical for a chemical and you're not really in this for trying to get clean, you won't be successful. Whether you go to a maintenance drug or not, it's all about being determined and having the desire to try and stop using or drinking whatever your choice drug is. Man, Suboxone has saved my ass in many ways, and so has Subutex, but I've also detoxed off Suboxone. I used to get it off the street before when I wasn't going to the clinic at some point during this history of mine. And I remember detoxing off of it, and it just felt like 7, 8, 10 days go by and you kind of feel the same bullshit feeling. But I was drinking at that time too. So it was like I was numbing whatever the effects were from the Suboxone detox with my alcoholism. And I didn't just drink a beer or two, because someone might go, well, that ain't gonna help. No, I was getting drunk every day. I'm an alcoholic as well. So it was one thing for another for many years. And I just want to share that with y'all, because methadone, I didn't consistently, and I don't have tons of experience with, but I've taken it, and I have taken it while detoxing, and it has taken the withdrawals away, but it didn't make me high, like people would say. In fact, I never really cared much for methadone. Never have. It just helped me in certain times when I was trying to get off heroin to quit. But most of the time, the mindset isn't really set on quitting, which is why cold turkey worked for me. My mind wasn't... The drugs kept making me feel comfortable. I felt like I didn't need to get clean, or it didn't make me take it as serious as I thought it should be. And that's the scary part for a drug addict. I'm gonna leave on this note. The fact that we don't want it, but we do, okay? That I don't wanna get clean, yes I do, is stronger while we're in active addiction. When you get high, you start thinking about getting clean. When you're not high, you want to get high. It's a battle that never ends because the mind is rewired. There's the habit formed, the chemicals required in the brain, and there's emotional issues, lots of things that arise as to why we want it. But man, I make this to say, no matter what path you take or think you need, if this isn't ready and isn't going into the game, trying and giving your all, surrender to the doctors. Go in, lay it out on the table and say, I need help. And I want to do what you're asking me to do the right way. I don't want to be on drugs the rest of my life. I don't want to stand in line at 5 a.m. Next to Billy Bob, who's been coming here for 15 years. I'm trying to get my life to where I don't require a substance to be happy. I know that may take me some time if I choose this route, but it's going to save my ass from the streets, from getting hepatitis C or HIV from a needle from someone else. And I could tell you stories about that from people that I know that are truly close and dearly loved ones of mine that have come close to those encounters. That's Suboxone, Subutex, and Methadone, just touching on it in my story, and I can share other stories pertaining to other substances, but I had personal experience with these. They can work and do work if they're used properly. You're not alone though. So if you're detoxing right now, getting past the detox is one thing, but I read messages all day, every week about how detoxing's one thing and it sucks and you think it'll never end, but once you're past it, that's not even the hard part. The hard part is staying clean. So get the mind right, get a strong foundation for recovery, wherever, however that is, whether it be 12-step, whether it be seeing a psychologist, psychiatrist, a counselor, inpatient treatment, outpatient, it doesn't matter. Some form of group, people, you need it. We need people. When you're detoxing and you're watching these videos and you're alone and you're feeling like, damn, I relate to what he's saying, you're feeling like somebody's with you. You're not alone. You know that it feels good to know someone else is going through this or someone has gone through this and they've made it successfully. I'm here for you. Derek Lambert is my name. Rewired Addiction is my game. Make sure you subscribe, like, share. Check the description out if you want to help this platform. I love you guys and gals. Until next time, I'm going to keep bringing the heat. Later.